Welcome to the Prep Athletics Podcast. This is Corey Heights.
Some battles. I'm not sure if they got us. If they did, maybe.
So you will get better as a player during that year.
So it was kind of exciting. Like, oh yeah, somebody wants me.
The big thing now, let's talk about current day. The class of 2021 has obviously missed out on a lot of recruiting with last summer and this basketball season. So this year, and even before COVID, you get tons of emails every day. You get tons of phone calls from coaches, from kids all over the world. How do you narrow down which kids you want to put into the bucket where you want to explore more? And I want to expand on that too. Like, what's something, what qualities do you want in a kid on your team as well?
Right. So great question. That one, it's kind of a stock answer, but I seem like I've been saying it for a couple of years now comfortably. So I'll lay it out here, but character kids are guys I'm looking for without question. You hear the word a lot. I do think it plays a greater role in today's world. I'm not entirely sure why, but character guys help you build teams, which obviously in this environment you need to do quickly. So character is something that I am absolutely interested in, right? Competitive kids, no question about it, okay? And I think that for a lot of reasons, but I want competitive kids. They tend to, what I tell parents is here are the kind of guys that do well by me. You know, and it, regardless of whether they're Division I or Division III players, a character guy, a competitive kid, a kid with toughness, mental or physical or both, right? But give me a tough kid, right? And that's, you need a tough kid to take on this environment. You need a tough, competitive kid to go to practice every day, to try to take on everything that we're talking about, right? To play the schedule that we're playing. You bet it, because we're not going to beat people with sheer talent. That's not the landscape for me these days, right? And then lastly, a kid that genuinely loves the game. And that, right, that meter's different for every kid, right? Some guys are 10 on that, and right, some, but for a kid that really genuinely loves the game, to me that smooths out the rough edges. If the year doesn't go exactly the way they hope it does, but he genuinely loves the game, there's usually a way we find it works out in the end. I mean, I can't tell you all the reasons why, but there's usually a happy ending. So when you piece those four things together for me, I'm looking for any guy that has those things. And then obviously too, talent is a piece of the equation. We get a variety of talent levels. So the marker for me there is, can this kid play college basketball somewhere? Does he want to play college basketball somewhere? Is he, is he ready to go take that on? So anyway, that's it. Like you said, I can't pretend to be, ace recruiter guy, because I know, I'm not in a position to do that. And I don't think it's entirely necessary. And I also am old enough to know that even at the college and NBA level, for God's sake, they don't get it right either. And they're spending, oodles of dollars trying to get it right every time. So it is a gamble or a crapshoot, like you say, and you just kind of, trust your instincts and gather the information you can. And then just, and they're rolling a dice on you, and I'm rolling a dice on them. So